In a Chinese marine park, a new bionic whale shark made its debut and amazed the world. This is the latest research and development of China Aerospace Science and Industry Corporation. The whale shark is 4.7 meters long and weighs 350 kilograms. This robot whale shark is really lifelike. It can swim freely in the water and is very flexible when it rises, dives, or turns. What's more, it moves almost silently and is very hidden. It looks and moves like a real whale shark, and it can perfectly imitate the opening and closing of the whale shark's mouth. Although China currently only puts it in the oceanarium for performance, the US military seems to be very concerned about this technology. They even worry that it may become a military threat. Although this sounds a bit exaggerated, no matter how powerful this robot whale shark is, it is impossible for it to swim to the US waters by itself. So why is the United States so sensitive to such a robot whale shark? What military potential does this robot whale shark have? If you like our video content, please click to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can receive all our latest video content. Now, let's get into today's topic. Everyone knows that the Earth we live on is basically a big ball surrounded by water. In fact, 70% of the Earth's surface is covered by water. But who is the real ruler of this vast water world? The answer is undoubtedly fish. Fish are fully adapted to the water environment. Through hundreds of millions of years of evolution, they have become the overlords of the underwater world. So far, humans have discovered more than 30,000 species of fish, and new species are discovered every year. These fish have different forms. Some are adapted to living in shallow waters, some can dive to the depths of thousands of meters, and others can swim thousands of kilometers in the ocean because of their maneuverability. It is precisely because of the unique characteristics of fish that they have attracted great interest from many scientific and technological workers. Over the past few decades, scientists around the world have hoped to draw inspiration from these fish to study and manufacture fish-like machines. Since more than 10 years ago, the US Navy has used the unique sensory abilities of dolphins, such as sound, vision, and smell, to complete various tasks. These smart marine mammals can accurately identify and locate targets such as obstacles, mines, and submarines on the seabed. Dolphins' keen sense of smell and echolocation ability make them a powerful assistant in mine clearance and bomb dismantling, and they can also track submarines for detection and surveillance. Due to their efficient detection capabilities, dolphins have played an important role in the operations of the US Navy. However, relying on biological forces for combat still brings many uncertainties. Therefore, scientists from all over the world are actively researching and developing marine bionic robot technology, and bionic fish is one of the important research directions. Not long ago, China showed the world a bionic robot super whale shark. So what exactly does this whale shark have? As far as I know, this bionic whale shark was actually developed as early as the end of 2021 and was originally publicly displayed in an oceanarium in Shanghai, China. This whale shark is 4.7 meters long and weighs 350 kilograms. Despite its huge size, it has shown flexibility that amazes everyone. In the water, this bionic whale shark can perform various actions smoothly, whether it is swimming in a straight line, turning flexibly, floating up easily, or diving quickly. It is done very freely. What is even more amazing is that the opening and closing of its mouth and gill slits are also extremely lifelike, making it almost impossible to tell the difference between it and a real whale shark. As part of the exhibition, this bionic whale shark makes people feel as if they are seeing a real whale shark swimming in front of them, and also brings an unforgettable viewing experience to the audience. Of course, in addition to being extremely similar to a real whale shark in appearance, this bionic whale shark is also extremely delicate in every detail and has excellent performance. It can swim at a speed of 0.7 meters per second, and can dive into waters up to 10 meters deep. What's more, it can also perform specific tasks such as bait throwing. As far as I know, it provides two operation modes, remote control and autonomous cruising, and people can choose the most suitable mode according to their needs. When it is active underwater, this robot whale shark is also very quiet and concealed, and it is almost unnoticeable. In addition, it is equipped with advanced communication sonar and Beidou navigation systems, which makes it like having a super brain, which can help it keenly perceive the surrounding environment and easily cope with complex underwater situations. It is worth noting that although the Bionic whale shark developed by China is only displayed in the oceanarium for viewing purposes, it has attracted great attention from the US military. The US military has a high evaluation of the performance of this Bionic whale shark and also pointed out that unmanned submarines may play a key role in future conflicts in the Pacific and South China Sea. The US even claimed that the ultra-short baseline positioning system carried by this whale shark can accurately locate and ensure that the submersible will not lose its way. And its sonar system gives it all-weather seabed perception capabilities and can quickly detect targets beyond the line of sight. If these technologies are used for military purposes, they may pose a huge threat to Southeast Asia and other neighboring countries. In response to these accusations, the China Aerospace Science and Industry Corporation officially responded that this bionic whale shark is only for viewing and has no intention of any military application. So why is the US reaction so strong when this bionic whale shark is just a display project in the oceanarium? In fact, the US's attention to this bionic whale shark is not completely unreasonable. Imagine if this technology is used for military purposes. This bionic whale shark can dive into the water and perform various reconnaissance missions, such as investigating the hydrological environment of the seabed or detecting underwater targets. Because of its extremely realistic appearance and swimming style, the enemy may mistake it for an ordinary fish. In this way, the bionic whale shark can conduct covert reconnaissance without being detected and even create opportunities for raids. Moreover, this bionic whale shark can also be equipped with various sensors for underwater search, including sonar, lidar, and magnetometer. If these devices are equipped, it can also interfere with or even attack the enemy's electronic systems by carrying various communications and electronic equipment. More extreme, it can even carry out suicide attacks, carrying bombs and mines, autonomously searching for targets in enemy ports, and actively launching attacks. What is most worrying is that the bionic whale shark can also form a highly collaborative network underwater through cluster collaboration to achieve more efficient search and attack. Such a strategy may cause enemy ships to fall into chaos and be difficult to deal with. Therefore, when the US military showed strong attention to this 350-kilogram bionic whale shark, it was actually considering that if this technology was used in the military, it might pose a serious threat to their ships and underwater facilities. But did you know that the United States was actually the first country in the world to develop bionic fish and apply it in the military field? As early as 1994, MIT built the first robot fish robotuna, which was modeled after tuna, which opened the prelude to the international research and development of bionic fish technology. Now, the United States not only continues to promote the development of this technology, but also plans to apply it to the military field. Among them, the Manta Ray unmanned submarine is a good example. The Manta Ray unmanned submarine is more than 15 meters wide and can work at a depth of about 300 meters underwater. Its payload is between 8 and 10 tons. It can carry a variety of equipment according to different mission requirements. Relying on artificial intelligence, big data, and advanced navigation technology, the Manta can adopt a swarm cluster combat mode, which allows it to identify, monitor, and track submarines and seabed resources in disputed waters and key waterways around the world, greatly enhancing its ability to perceive the seabed situation. A prominent feature of the Manta is its modular design, which allows it to be quickly assembled and deployed instantly, almost without any geographical restrictions. This flexibility and advanced design concept make the Manta a very important underwater reconnaissance tool in the modern military. In order to ensure that it can perform missions for a long time without being discovered, American scientists have equipped the Manta unmanned submersible with some cutting-edge technology, allowing it to use solar panels for power supply. And when it is active underwater, it can also use the temperature difference of seawater to generate electricity. In this way, even the Manta can get a steady supply of electricity for long-term projects in the deep sea. In order to manage these energy sources more intelligently, the Manta has introduced an advanced energy management system and can switch to a sleep mode with lower power consumption when needed, which greatly extends its stealth time. Of course, the size of this submersible is relatively large, but this also means that it can carry a lot of equipment. It is equipped with high-resolution cameras and multifunction sonars, as well as precise underwater positioning systems, as well as command and control, autonomous control, communication, and data storage equipment. In addition, its payload compartment space is adjustable and can be resized according to mission needs, which is very flexible. As the Manta gradually approaches the actual combat deployment stage, the U.S. Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency and the U.S. Navy are working closely to plan its subsequent testing phase and the path to its eventual integration into the Navy system. Therefore, although China currently has no plans to use bionic whale sharks for military purposes, given the future trend of technological development, once the United States begins to use similar bionic fish technology for military purposes, China may also consider taking corresponding actions. After all, in terms of performance, China's bionic fish is not inferior to that of the United States in many aspects, and some technologies are even better than those of the United States. In addition to China and the United States, many countries such as France, Sweden, and the United Kingdom are actually also researching bionic submersibles. So, do you think China will use bionic fish in wars in the future? To not miss out on our future projects and news updates, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications. We will continue to provide you with more exciting and interesting content.